Topiramate is one of the anti-epileptic drug that is indicated for the treatment of seizures. It is the second generation anti-epileptic agent that acts by multiple mechanisms. Because of this, Topiramate is having the wide uses other than seizures. This medication can also be used to prevent migraine headaches. Since this drug modifies neuronal activity, it can reduce the migraine attacks. And even this drug can be used for weight management along with another drug, phentermine, in a fixed combination. Apart from these indications, Topiramate can be used for many of the conditions as off-label purpose. So it is very essential to know important facts about Topiramate. In this video, we are going to cover such key facts about this medication. Clinical uses. Topiramate is primarily indicated for treatment of seizures, and it is used in the treatment of generalized tonic-clonic seizures as well as for partial onset seizures. In both of these conditions, either Topiramate can be used alone or it can be combined with other medications as adjunctive therapy. Topiramate can be used both in the adults as well as in the children. In the children with age 2 years or above, this medication can be used. Similarly, Topiramate can be used as an adjunctive therapy in the children with age 2 to 16 years. Another important clinical use of Topiramate is in the treatment of Lennox-Gastaut syndrome. This is one of the epileptic disorder that is observed in the children, and it is one of the severe form of epilepsy. This type of epilepsy is observed in the childhood, and it may be developed in the early age of 1 to 5 years. Topiramate can be used to treat this condition in the children with age 2 years or above. But here, Topiramate can be used along with other drugs, so it is used as adjunct in this therapy. Another clinical indication for the treatment of migraine headaches. Since Topiramate modifies the neuronal activity, it can reduce the frequency as well as severity of migraine headaches. However, it may take around 6 months to show full beneficial effects of this medication in reducing migraine attacks. Topiramate can also be combined with another medication, phentermine, for the treatment of overweight. In the people with body mass index greater than 30 kg per square meter, these two drugs can be used at a fixed combination. Topiramate causes loss of appetite, which reduces the food intake, thereby it can produce weight loss. That's why it can be combined with phentermine for the treatment of overweight. These are the few clinical use of Topiramate. However, it can be used for other conditions as off-label purpose for treating many of the eating disorders. But one of its primary approved indication is in the treatment of epilepsy. What is the doses of this medication? Topiramate is available as tablets as well as capsules. These capsules are available as sprinkle capsules, where the capsule can be opened and the content can be sprinkled on soft foods. These sprinkle capsules are used for those people who are not able to swallow these tablets. Capsules are also available as extended-release formulations, which deliver the medication for longer periods in the day. It is also available as oral suspension. The tablets and capsules are available at various strengths starting from 25 mg to 200 mg. The oral suspension is available at a strength of 25 mg per ml. Dose of Topiramate depends on many factors like age of the patient, purpose of use, and other medications co-prescribed. Generally, it can be started at a low dose, and the dose can be slowly escalated on weekly basis. For the treatment of epilepsy, it can be started at a dose of 50 mg given in divided doses. The dose can be slowly escalated to a maximum dose of 400 mg per day, which is again given as divided doses. However, for preventing migraine attacks, Topiramate is started at a low dose, and the dose range may be variable from 25 to 200 mg per day. So the starting dose is 25 mg and the maximum dose is 200 mg per day. How it acts? In the brain, glutamate is one of the important neurotransmitters which is released from the neurons. This glutamate can act on its receptors like AMPA as well as kainate. These two are the inotropic receptors which open fast-acting sodium channels resulting in excitation within the brain. Now, topiramate can block this AMP as well as kinate receptors. Thereby, it can inhibit the excitation. In this way, it can modify neuronal signaling. Thereby, it can reduce the excitation. Topiramate can also increase the inhibitory activity by increasing the GABA action. It can also block voltage-gated calcium channels. All these can result in decreased excitation. Another action of topiramate is on the acid levels. Topiramate can inhibit activity of carbonic anhydrase enzyme. This results in the increased levels of acids in the brain, leading to acidosis. This metabolic acidosis can inhibit the activity of NMDA receptors. These are the receptors for glutamate. Thereby, the glutamate action is inhibited. By all these actions, topiramate can reduce the excitation within the brain, which inhibits epileptic activity. Effect on vision. Use of topiramate can produce some blurred vision, which is commonly observed and well tolerated. But in few people, it can produce severe conditions like eye pain, redness of the eye, and some increased pressure in the eye. These symptoms indicate a serious condition because topiramate can increase the risk of pressure in the eye, which should be carefully monitored. If it is untreated, it can produce loss of vision. Therefore, care should be taken to monitor these serious side effects. It can also produce some double vision, which is common in many people. Metabolic acidosis. Just we have discussed that topiramate can inhibit the carbonic anhydrase activity. This can affect the kidneys, resulting in the loss of bicarbonate. As the bicarbonate is more lost from the body, it results in the increased acid levels, leading to metabolic acidosis. This acidosis in the brain can inhibit the glutamate activity, which can reduce the epilepsy. But at the same time, it may produce adverse effects on the periphery. In case of severe metabolic acidosis, the patients may have difficulty breathing and rapid heartbeats. If you observe these symptoms, it may indicate a serious condition. Effect on kidney. Topiramate can increase the risk of kidney stones. Since topiramate is going to inhibit the carbonic anhydrase activity, it can increase the metabolic acidosis, which increases the risk of kidney stones. So in the people with high levels of acids, the kidney functionality may be reduced. In such people, care should be taken to avoid any ketogenic diet because this type of diet can further increase the risk of kidney stones. Effect on memory. Topiramate can reduce the memory in few of the people and it can reduce the ability to concentration. You may have difficulty with attention and concentration and a state of confusion may be produced. It can also produce some difficulty in speech and lack of attention. What are the side effects? The important side effects of topiramate mainly include the dizziness. It can produce lightheadedness and it can also increase the somnolence, sleepiness in the people. You may feel tired with use of topiramate and it can also produce loss of appetite. This loss of appetite results in the weight loss, which is an advantage in the people with overweight. However, in people with normal weight, this may result in weight loss. It can also produce some confusion, nervousness, paresthesia, loss of sensation, and a sensation of pinning and stinging can be observed. People using topiramate may have less psychomotor activity, so they have the slow reactions towards emotional and behavioral actions. It can also produce abdominal pain, blurred vision, as well as double vision. Dry mouth is another important side effect and it can also produce some taste changes in the people. Effect on mood. Since topiramate acts on the brain, it can modify mood and behavior in the people. With long-term use of topiramate, people may have depressive symptoms, which is more pronounced in the young and adolescent people. They may have increased state of anxiety as well as agitation and aggression. Along with such symptoms, any mood changes may increase the risk of suicidal thoughts. So in the people with any abnormal mood changes and other depressive symptoms, topiramate should be carefully used. So these are the important facts about this medication, topiramate, which is one of the widely used anti-epileptic medication, which acts by multiple mechanisms. It is a second generation anti-epileptic agent indicated for the treatment of seizures. But it can also be used to prevent migraine attacks, as well as for weight management. Dizziness and loss of memory are important side effects produced by this medication. So that's all about the key facts about topiramate. I hope this video is useful to you. Thank you for watching this video. See you in the next video.